Today, my friends, we're here to teach you guys Lavaloon at Town Hall 11. We've got three different attack strategies to showcase the Lavaloon and its power, and we're going to break them down along with how to use the Lavaloon portion. So this first section, we're going to be going over a couple things. We're going to be going over the basics of the Lavaloon, mainly with the key objectives, the number of loons, and the spells. Then we're going to get into the strategies that we have here for you guys and break them down very carefully, step by step, in order for you guys to easily use these three attacks. Now, first of all, with any Lavaloon attack, what are your key objectives? What are your main key objectives? Primarily, it's going to be the enemy queen and enemy CC. These two structures are going to be really important to get, as the queen can actually completely wreck you, especially if you don't take her out. There are a couple ways of taking her out within this video. You're going to see different ways of Electrone. You're also going to see Sui Hero with some skeleton spells, and you're going to see a queen charge. So there are a lot of different ways to deal with the queen with the Lalo. Now, the next thing that you want to make sure that you're looking at is, what are some other pieces of value that I can get from a base design with any of the kill squads? Well, let's talk about this. Sui Hero, you're going to look for stuff like air defenses, wizard towers, archer towers on the outside of the base. That way you can easily pick them off and you're getting some value from there. You're also trying to set a funnel defensively for them. So getting those defensive buildings down, that way you can control their pathing a little bit easier. Now, another thing is, you with the Electrone, you're looking for a lot of stuff. You're trying to look for air sweepers. You're looking to get the eagle. It's not mandatory to get, unless, you know, you can get it really easily, but that's just really going to be up to you and how the base is designed. And another thing that you're going to be looking for are stuff like expos, air defenses, obviously the queen and the CC, and, you know, wizard towers. So there's a lot of things that you can get with an Electrone, and you'll see that within this example later on, but it's still a very, very good way. And then charge is very similar like Electrone. You're just looking for as much value from the inside of the base, still to control their pathing a little bit easier. Now, the last thing I want to go over is spells. Spells are always going to be really important, and they're going to range from, you know, bringing heal and a Sui to bringing rage spells with your queen charge. So there are a lot of different things. Now, at Town 11, remember that you can hold a rage or something very similar to that size in your CC. That means what you're going to be able to do is bring a rage spell. So like in the Electrone case, you're bringing Rage typically with the kill squad, which is your Electrone kill squad. Other times Rage spells would be used are stuff like in a Sui to deal with the Queen with the Skelly spells, and also with a Queen charge. So that's the only time that you would use a Rage. Heal, on the other hand, you would be bringing only with the Sui, or an Electrone depending on the spell composition and the army composition of your own attack. Now, haste spells are predominantly used all around Lalo, as what you want to do is you want to get those loons to those key defenses. Like you see right here, you want to make sure that you're going from defense to defense in order to get them to those key ones. Those key ones being stuff like wizard towers, the eagle, archer towers, and expos, and along with multi-infernos as well. But those are going to be your key things to actually haste through. That's going to be one of the biggest things. Now, before I end you guys off, we want to make sure that we are going to be taking a look at the number of loons down at the bottom, like you see right here. You're going to see the number of loons per defense to one-shot them. It's a really important number, and I would say that this is a really, really good thing to memorize. Come back to this video if you really need to understand it, or any of the other videos I have, because any other video I have covering Lalo still shows the same information, but it shows different base designs, which really will help, since that is exactly what I'm trying to do. I may do a lot of these videos, a lot of the same information. Every base design's different though. But now let's go ahead and move on to the first strategy we have, which is going to be this one, the Electrone. So here's how Electrone Lalo works. There are a couple factors that we need to understand with this attack, and we're going to be going by this step by step. First of all, we're going to be starting off with a Sui Hero. This is typically done with the King and or the queen, which we can still save, especially if there's like a lava hound in the CC, then we can definitely use the queen a little bit later on. But she's not going to be as necessary to use, especially if she can't get an air defense. So one of the biggest things is when you're trying to take a look at a base and determining whether or not you should use a slammer or a blimp, let's go ahead and go over that really quickly. First of which, we want to talk about where the town hall is placed. That is step one. You want to look at that. So when you're scouting, look at where the town hall is. Is it in the center? Then if it is, then that might be a good area to actually use a blimp, since the blimp can just travel anywhere right to that center. Now, if it's an anti-3 like you see here, it's going to determine on where the queen and the CC are placed. From here, we notice that the queen is actually going to be away from the town hall, which allows us to use a blimp in this area. Another factor that allows us to do this is the air sweeper placement. If we look at it right here, we've got one air sweeper pointing like this. And then over here, we have another air sweeper pointing in this direction. What this allows us now to do is see, all right, where's a good spot to drop in our blimp? Well, if we drop it in right here, this gets us some good value, and we're going through the blind spot of those air sweepers, meaning that we're not going to have to go through them, which is always going to be a huge help for us. Now, on top of this, we won't be able to get to the eagle just because it's by that town hall. If we wanted to use a slammer, then we could. But also, the main reason to why we wouldn't is, notice how these defenses are placed where it's going to keep our stone slammer on the outside at all times. So we want to make sure that we're using a blimp to get our electrum portion in the base. So that's the main reasons to why we're using a blimp in this case. Two clone spells are usually more than enough for this attack, as two clones are able to do a lot of damage, and with those clone loons doing a lot, they can really pull in a lot of traps and also take out defenses. Now, one of the biggest things with this is you are looking for at least one air defense with this attack, and then, of course, the enemy CC and enemy queen. So those are just going to be a couple things that you really need to understand with the Electrum. Other than that, it's a very, very simple strategy. There isn't a lot to it. I used it a lot at Town Hall 11, and I really, really enjoyed it, even if I wasn't the best at it. I still got, like, high percentage 2-stars, but I'm, of course, not the best attacker. Now, one of the biggest things that you're going to be starting out with, like you see right here, is going to be the Sui hero. You're starting out with the king. We are using him right here just so that then he kind of moves over and grabs this wizard tower. That's some good value there, and we don't really need to worry about it. So that's a large plus for us just using our king. If we used our queen too, we would probably get some more extra value, but we decide to just use our king here in order to get value from that side. Now we have the blimp going into the base as we start to move in. You'll see that it does damage over time. And remember that the blimp did get a buff a while back to where it does have this death bomb where it does a lot of damage. So you'll see that the rage spell is going down because the queen is now locked onto the battle blimp, meaning that it will go down a little bit quicker. Now, that means that we're going to use a rage and two clone spells in order to clone up these loons. That way, we're going to be able to use our battle blimp in order to take out the queen, air defense, and also the multi-inferno, like you see right here. So we're looking for these three structures here. Now, what about the enemy CC? Like you see that it is being pulled out. Well, it's not going to be too difficult, as you can see right here, easily dealing with the enemy queen. Then it moves right onto the enemy CC, and boom. Look at all the value that we received from that section there. That's really all that we were trying to look for with this portion, and that's about it. Now, with that being said, we did have a couple of our clone loons pushed back, but that also offers us some good value here. What this allows us now is we can send in our lava loon portion with cloned loons there being involved, which is always going to be a huge plus because having more loons in a lava loon portion can sometimes be very, very good. Of course, they're temporary, but still having them is quite nice. Now, let's talk about hounds and tanking. This is a big aspect here, and this is a really, really big thing. So take a look at all of the defenses targeting or around this air defense. Wizard towers, the expos right here, the archer tower. That's some good tanking right there. So you want to make sure that when you're taking a look at a base design, you're looking at the air defense placement and see, are the hounds going to tank just enough for those loons as they move right through the base? So you'll see that the loons are going around the base, having the heal spell, and or well, not the heal, the haste, and the haste spells are getting them right up through. One thing though to quickly mention, the Grand Warden ability, you'll see that we're using it right over the eagle, and the main reason to why is we are going into now a multi-inferno with a, you know, with only a half health hound, meaning that we need to keep them alive as we start to send everything in. We still have three hastes, and you can also notice that the queen is there helping as well. That's always going to be a huge help, and even a free spell can be very, very useful in a lava loon. So there's a lot of different things that just happened there, and let me explain. Queen can be used on the outside of the base in order to get value from that, and also to control the padding of the Lalo, make it a little bit easier on that back end. Now, the other thing that you would be using your heal spell for is to make sure that, for one, the Inferno and the air defense are completely taken care of. That way the lava or the balloons can get right up to them with a haste spell. That's really why you would be using that. But other than that, it's a very simple way of three-starring, and this entirely goes step by step on really the lava loon, the electron, and all of that in this one sort of replay. But with that being said, let's move on to the next one, which is going to be Sui Lalo. So here's the next one, and this one is our Sui Lalo, and this is still a very strong strategy, and if you guys have never seen my Sui Lalo video, I'm going to leave a link up there as a card in the description, or, well, not in the description, but right there as a card, that way you can see my Lava Loon video on Sui Lalo in order to learn that one a little bit better, but let's go ahead and briefly go over this one within this section. So, first of which, you are looking for the enemy queen. However, in this case, there is a lava hound and a balloon within the CC. Typically, this type of CC is going to be more common in videos where you'll see me, you know, showing the Sui Lalo, but you can still deal with the enemy CC. It's actually not that hard. You can just use, you know, the lava pups in order to take out the baby dragon. Not too difficult, but of course, unlike anything else, this example will not show a damage CC. However, we are going to be seeing a Sui hero and these skeleton spells underneath a rage in order to kill off the enemy queen. We're also going to pair that up with a free spell over the multi-inferno, and you'll see why in a second. So we're going to be first starting out with just the Sui hero portion. We're just clearing this side here. And the main reason to why is if we take a look at the base design, it would be a little bit strange if we didn't clear this area out. Because what this does is that now gives us this area funneled out, allowing us to do our Lalo in a counterclockwise manner, which is going to help us a lot. That way, what we're going to be able to do is just use our Stone Slammer and the Loons and the Lava Hounds to work their way around the base. That's really all this strategy is. It's just using your Sui hero, which is your king and queen, just to make sure that you're getting some value from there. And then after that, you can just Lalo and make sure that you're just keeping in mind where that queen is. Using a free spell is actually a great synergy with the skeleton spell, because you don't want that queen to move. Just keep that in mind. So, as we take a look at this example, let's first take a look at the Sui hero, and this is a really, really important part of this attack. Of course, it's just as the name provides, Sui Lalo, it's really important to use the Sui hero here. So you'll see that what we're doing is we're not getting value, you know, like, you know, air defenses, wizard towers, we're not doing that, because here's the reason why. That area was open to it, and it allows us to create a funnel defensively for the loons. That way what we're allowed to do is use our loon pathing just so that then the loons can actually work their way around the base a little bit easier. That's going to help us a lot as we work our way around. See, if we didn't clear that section out, the Stone Summer would be going here and not into the Archer Tower. So, there's a lot of things just to keep in mind. So you'll see that what we're doing is we're using the Stone Slammer as a Lava Hound loon, you know, mix, but we're using it as a tank. And then we sent in the Lava Hound as we start to send in. This is where we're going to drop in a rage, a freeze, right on top of that queen, and then the skelly spells like you see right here. So the main reason to why we're using our rage spells there is in order to make sure that the skeleton spells, even though they do have shields, in order to surround that queen, take her out, and have that little bit of a buff from the rage spell itself, and then using the freeze on top of both the queen and the multi-inferno, since that multi-inferno will completely wreck those skellies, making sure that we drop in that freeze allows us to safely safeguard that, and then also kill off the queen very, very easily, like you'll see right here. So we're going to mainly just stay focused on that. You can see that they are killing off the queen. Once they've done so, they can start moving away. And as that happens, we can then also use a heal. You'll notice that we're not using the heal, you know, with the loons over by the multi-inferno, like right here. That would probably would have given better value. But we're using the heal right here primarily, just because we want to make sure that we're healing the group that's going in this direction here. That way, what this allows us to do is it allows us to keep our loons alive, keep them full health, as we only have a couple spells left. With that being said as well, we do have the Grand Warden ability, and that would be primarily used around that same time, or even by a multi-inferno. There's just a lot of reasons to why you would want to use it earlier rather than later, but other than that, it's still very simple nonetheless. Remember that we are using our lava pups and the minions as cleanup. They're great cleanup troops and they allow us to get some extra value. With that being said, you'll see that we don't have any more spells. However, we do still have a poison which we can, you know, use over the lava enemy lava pups, and we can also use that over any of the skeleton traps that are set to air. But you'll see that even with not having any more spells, we can still get through that back end portion with no issue. That's really why this strategy is really, really strong and it works very, very well. So with that being said, we're going to move on to our final attack strategy with Lavaloon, which is going to be Queen Charge Lalo. So the last example that we have here for you guys is going to be Queen Charge Lalo. And we're going to be showing you guys the Quad Quake version. There was a little bit of a harder version, which was using 12 wall breakers. Yeah, you heard me right. But showing as the Quad Quake one is going to be a little bit better, and it allows you to sort of take a look at a different way of using a queen charge with a Quad Quake. It's a lot better to do that. Wall breakers, there's a little bit more skill involved. Now, with that being said, we're trying to take a look at value from the outside. So, or not really from the outside, but we're trying to look for value that we can get with a queen charge, because we're looking for a lot. The queen can pick over walls. Heck yeah, we would try to use that. So when we're taking a look at the base design here, you would think, oh yeah, let's charge right into here. But we want to get this eagle. So that means that what we want to do is we want to use our Quad Quake around this area here, which allows us to start our queen walk here, walk our queen into this section. This now gives us access to the enemy CC and enemy queen, and also to the eagle, one air defense, a wizard tower, an expo. That just offers us some good value there for our queen charge. And even though we may not be able to get to one of these two infernos, as long as we're keeping our queen alive with the rage spells are going to be really important. We'll kind of take a look why. You may notice that we're not bringing that many haste. As the main reason here is because, you know, we want to get as much value as possible so that then we could use as little hastes as possible. That's why we're bringing in 4 quake spells that allows us to break open any level of wall, and then that allows us to use our rage spells to keep our queen alive, get deeper into the base, and then also use our Lavaloon portion to get as much value as possible from that. And don't forget, we also are using the Stone Slammer. So the Stone Slammer we can use as a tank. So if we take a look at this example, starting with this first section here, primarily we are looking to get our queen into the base by starting off with the charge. Make sure that what you're doing here is that you are not dropping in all of your, healers right at that second. Make sure that she is starting to take damage before you drop them in, just so that then, you know, there's no reason to drop in your healers if, you know, your queen hasn't, you know, taken any damage. Once she does that, then she's going to start taking more damage, and that's when you're going to use your healers. So as you can see, the quad quake goes down. That offers us some good value and opens us up to the enemy CC, which is the main reason why we are using a rage spell, just to deal with that. There are a couple reasons to when we would use a rage spell: when we're dealing with the enemy CC, when we're dealing with the enemy queen, and also to keep the queen alive against a lot of DPS or the king. That is just going to be some really quick information. I know that I do have a queen walk / queen charge guide coming out very soon this week, so definitely look forward to that. Now, as we take a look at this, you'll see that we're using our rage spells just to keep our queen alive. You can see, as she's dealing with the enemy CC, even under that haste, we want to make sure that we are using the rage spells to take her out. Now, once that's happened, we don't really need to use the rage spells anymore unless we want to continue with that charge. So you'll see, as we continue to move here, we're going to start sending in our lava loom portion. We can start sending everything in like this. That allows us to really sort of get a lot of good value from the rest of our attack. Now, of course, unlike anything else, we want to make sure that our warden is still going in with our loons. Like you can see, it wasn't going in with anything, just hitting the gold storage. But we really want to make sure that we are really saving our haste spells as much as possible to get them through those key defenses. Grand Warden ability over the multi-inferno, that actually is a very, very good thing. So that example is a really good way to sort of understand how you guys can use this portion more effectively. But I know this was a long video, but the lava loon is a really, really important topic to go over. And I hope I broke this video down step by step in order to teach you guys the lava loon correctly with these three different type of lava loons. If you guys did enjoy, remember to leave a like and subscribe for more of this content. And feel free to also hit the notification bell so you guys don't miss anything. Also, feel free to go ahead and join my community Discord. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and also follow me on Twitch and or subscribe there as well, as we are working our way up to getting more sub badges there, or more subs, or I guess more sub points that we can use to get more sub badges. So with that being, or emotes, I mean. But with that being said, I'm also going to put down in the description the clans I'm covering. Feel free to join any of them. Just follow their instructions on Discord and you will be all set to go. But with that being said, guys, that's going to do it for the video. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll be seeing you guys next time. Corrupt, signing out.